This is Jason Wilcox coming back. We're reporting once again. I'm back to the grow room. We've been fighting an allergy to protect just this, the right to grow. The right to grow flowers, the right to grow big, huge buds, the right to walk through a grow room like this and experience the freedom of growing a plant. That's what this is all about. Welcome back to Cannabis Canada with Jason Wilcox, the real cannabis in Canada. We're celebrating a win in our... All right, activated charcoal filter. Boom, here it is. Otherwise known as scrubbers. You've seen this around. But up here, this is just for scrubbing the air. Make sure it's clean. Before it goes out to the outside, you don't want smell around your place. That's where it is. There's six of these that do the whole unit just on the upper floor. 5-ton ECU, 60,000 BTU. That's what it's putting out. 60,000 BTU, 60,000 BTU, 60,000. You do the math, but it is an amazing facility up here. Dehumidification, one of the most important parts of a standard grow-op. Keeping your relative humidity at all times in the proper range. This baby will do it. It's the Quest 155 dual system. All right, so water conservation, another big thing. Recycling your water. When the plants transpire, they kick up a lot of water. That's what this facility does. Recycles its own water, which is another huge part of being efficient in the grow room. All right, so here we are now. For any good grow, you have to have a water chiller if you're gonna be running hydroponics. This whole facility is on hydroponics. Keeping the water at a steady 70 degrees is what this facility does, using this baby right here, your water chiller. All right, so we got a Growonix two-stage water filtration system here, and this is very important. It gets rid of chlorine and chloramine, which is something that basically kills beneficial bacteria, which you absolutely need in your rooting zone. It's a fundamental thing that you have in a hydroponic system. Well, as I'm sitting in this jungle, this amazing jungle of friggin' mothers, it's amazing to sit here and know I'm Sour Diesel, we got White Castle, we got Moby Dick, Jackie White, Nebula, we got, Bubba Kush, OG Kush, Purple Candy Kush, Trainwreck, Super Silver Haze, Pink Kush, Rockstar Kush, Chemo. Man, the list goes on. I just cannot say enough about how important a propagation room is and how important it is, different strains for different pains. All right, so as we're here in the propagation room, this is a fundamental base for any grow room. In here, they just happen to have all the mothers. Now, some people have one strain, some people have multiple strains. Remember, different strains for different pains. Now, here we got two 1,000 metal halide bulbs. It's a blue spectrum that they look at. Now, traditionally, people have used metal halide for veg and then high-pressure sodium for flower. Now, they have cross-spectrum bulbs. This grower has chosen to use the traditional metal halide, 1,000 watt. There's only two of them, but look at these bushes. They go all the way around, and there's, most importantly as well, not only the size, but how healthy, the positive topism. Now let's talk about something that you growers want to know about, phenotypes. Look at them. You can sit here and look at more of a C. afghanica. You get a bit of a rounded here. Look down at the thin tip leaves here for the sativa. You got the sativa dominance. We see the indica dominance as well coming out. A lot of hybrids. All around me are hybrids. A lot of thick indicas in the back. Oh, I just can't wait till you see the B-roll, because all these plants here show the true phenotypes of what you need. Different strains to different pains. All these plants will provide a different set of cannabinoids and will help you medically no matter what. Unless you're an alien, you don't got CB1 and CB2 receptor cells, these plants will help you, and these different strains will all help different pains for me and for you. Starting out with any clone, again, you're going to come out, eventually your roots are going to come out through the bottom of your clone, and at that time you're going to take this clone and transplant it into your 4-inch rockwool cube. And then this will then be staged into the next cube up, which is a 6-inch rockwool cube, and then it'll go into its final staging, as we'll show as we go on. And other plants in this room are basically just in dirt. Some have been transferred to mothers, if you're wondering, are not running on hydroponics like the rest of the facility. These are in dirt. This is basically ProMix, and I'm assuming it looks like just ProMix. I'm not sure if it's mixed with cocoa. I will check with the facilitator of this facility, but in here, this is just dirt, and these mothers look amazing. I can't wait for you guys to see all these trees, because they're up to the roof and all healthy. And most important, bug control. In your fundamental base, if you start with bugs, you're gonna end with disaster. So a clean, proper propagation room to start with will help you along the way to finish a proper crop and to have a successful, bountiful crop for your time put in. All right, so as we continue to look around the room, you can see these have grown up to again 47 inches before they flip into photosynthesis, which is 12 and 12, to go into full flower. And as you can see, every leaf in this room, there should be a little trickle. See these leaves? They've got these little trickle to them? That's optimum airflow. You have to have airflow in the room. You can see all around here, there's oscillating fans that are blowing down and keeping the airflow. It's imperative to have airflow in your room. The air exchange in your room should be 1 to 3 times per minute. This room is clearly climate controlled and optimized. As we look around the lighting, we've got the parabolic shades, and we can go around, we can see there's 28 1,000 watt metal halide lights. Now, I talked about this in the other room. In veg, you look for the blue spectrum, you're gonna go with the metal halides, which is more of a, it looks like it's white, but it's actually the blue spectrum the plants are picking up on when you're looking at the light spectrum. But then you switch over to high pressure sodium in the flower chamber, which we'll show you. The lights change into more of an orange, which signals autumning and also helps the plant to continue flowering for optimal flower growth in these final stages. With this being a full-on recirculating water system, you can actually see the roots of this particular plant here. They just follow the water source going down into the drain here. Once again, going down this trough, you got 7 different plants in this particular one, and it just goes right across the room. And then you see they run up to the 6-inch rock wool cubes as we showed before, and this is their next stage before, once again, they go over into the flowering room. It's very important. The pH is always kept between 6 and 6.2 in that general area. Sometimes it'll go up to 6.3 is what I'm told. And that's where this particular grower and these particular plants like to stay in. PPM range for your electroconductivity is going to be between 1,000 and 1,200. As always, it's kind of a general to each their own when you dial those things in. And it's also strain dependent dialing them in. But this particular system is just amazing. It blows my mind to see the optimal control that you can put in basically in a football field if you wanted to, if you had that ability. All right, so here we are. We're sitting with the recycling. So this is a 200-gallon reservoir. I've never seen one this big. You walk right across it. The feeding system, we're going to get into all of it here, but basically when we talked about the recirculating water system inside there, we've covered everything. Basically, it completely is just continually recycling the water through the plants, full hydroponic system through this entire facility. With that being said, there's also the Green Planet products that this particular grower likes to use. Green Planet Nutrients, it's a new 3-part nutrient. It's going amazing. It's very popular online. It's very popular amongst growers, period. The feedback that I've been getting and the results that I've been seeing, it's phenomenal. Water, all that's continually running through the plants, back and forth, back and forth. And then the 3-part nutrient, being Green Planet Nutrients, you know, is what they're using here. It's an amazing product. I've used Green Planet for years with Medi One, being an organic grower, so I don't know what it's like to actually use this particular product because I don't run hydroponics in my garden. But this particular grower does, and the results are phenomenal. I can't say enough about it. It speaks for itself. It's off the hook. And yeah, I've got to return back to this. The other thing that's interesting about this particular reservoir is that they actually inject dissolved oxygen, I believe is what it's called. This is new to me because I've never done this, but injecting that into the water apparently really helps with getting the air into your rooting system, which is very important. You know, you want to get that air into your rooting system for your root mass. And this is something we need to look at. And once again, it speaks to the volume of professionalism and importance to safety. The whole way this place has been constructed, this facility, being able to go over your res like this and check it. These guys change their water, I believe it's every week. So it's every 7 days that this is changed in here. I mean, it's just an amazing facility. I can't continue to say enough about it. Again, touching back on the Green Planet Nutrients, it's a 3-part. Check into it, look it up, mygreenplanet.com, check them out. These are the cats that know where it's at. They can get you the stuff all around the world, and this is the product that you need. I'm old school Medi One, as I said, but this is where it's at for hydroponics if you're not growing in dirt. Okay, as we continue to walk down through the chamber here, I'm able to show you, most importantly, is when you're gauging what your nutrients, you want to know what's going on. Here you can see they got it at pH of 6, and then for their PPMs, for their nutrients, is basically 1040. Like we said, between 1,000 and 1,200 PPM is what you want to be ideal for your nutrients when you're measuring them. And you can see they're bang on, spot on here, and spot on with their pH as well. And of course, the temperature, as I said earlier, was 70. Here you can see it's picking it up right now at 69. And of course, it's gonna fluctuate a little bit with the gauges. All right, so here we are back in the bud room. Now, I hear a lot of people talking online and talking about looking at the size of pop bottles towards buds. And this is a lateral bud. This isn't even the terminal bud. This isn't the top one. This is just one of the laterals. I mean, look at this stuff. Just a mad, mad room. And again, fully hydroponics, fully recirculating system. Same idea, only individual stationary troughs for each one, but all being fully fed, recycling through those big reservoirs and optimal control. And clearly with plants like this, these are monster trees. These are trees. You talk about cannabis, is it a plant, is it a tree? This is a tree definition. Flowers 101. I love this bud room. Want to know what truly growing is? This is what we've been fighting for, friends. Our flowers, our trees, our plants. We're in the flowering room. Amazing. I'm in Candyland here. Look at the bud. My head. Bud, my head. It's amazing. This is just like a pound on the top of each of these trees. This is just one tree. This is some amazing stuff in here. We got some pink kush and some other strains going on in here. I'm gonna climb down from this ladder. I got this metal halide hid just sitting right behind me. It will burn my head. But this is the final chamber. This is the flower room.
This is blossoming at a hydroponic shop in BC. Sales have been smoking hot ever since two US states legalized marijuana. The company called Green Planet carries everything anyone would need to grow plants, any kind of plants, indoors. In Colorado, it is now legal to have six marijuana plants in a secure area.